understand the current audio is really bad. This is for the comparison how the HyperX Solocast actually performs compared to this current audio. We have a USB type A to type C cable. We have the instruction manual. You can read if you want. It will guide you through the basic functions of the microphone. Then comes the mic itself, and it's well caged inside this plastic shell, which is weirdly tough to get out. Yes, holding the mic in hand feels quite nice, and you have a lot of flexibility. Yeah, not the 100% thing, still it's okay. Yeah, the stand is made quite nice, and we have a cover at the top. We'll peel it off, and this one is your tap to mute. We'll show that how it works in a little bit. At the bottom, you have a cover, three rubber pads, which actually helps to stabilize your stand so that it doesn't wobble around. You have the Type-C port in which this cable part goes, and the other part definitely goes to the computer. The cage is made of solid metal, so yeah, it's quite nicely built. The subsequent joint really helps to move, and you have a attaching hot shoe mount at the bottom. So now I have connected the Solocast using the USB onto my computer, and it should start recording right away. You can see the LED indicator it shows, and it shows the power is on. So now you are actually allowed to record. And yes, at the top you have the tap to mute button. If you tap it once, yes, the audio gets muted, and if you tap again, it will start recording again. This is how the audio quality sounds like recording on the HyperX Solocast. If I tap on the top, well, to give it a small summary, if you are interested in buying this HyperX Solocast, I will give a link in the description. You can click and get one. It's totally available in Amazon, and the current listing price is around 5,790. So yes, it's not really on the cheaper side. If you are wanting to have a very, very ultra budget solution to get some good quality audio, you should definitely check out the lavalier type of mics, which is essentially a small microphone which attaches to your cloth or your like shirt in which, and then it's externally recorded, or you can directly sync it with your video. This HyperX Solocast works in a similar fashion, but it has some more processing, and it has a condenser built in, so the output is totally good, and the loudness levels and the treble levels are quite good. Yes, at this price you really can't complain. I think this is a great choice for a lot of budget consumers and a lot of folks who are actually thinking to start their YouTube channel, and actually the audio is as important as the video, if not more. So I would highly recommend you to check this mic out, and if it falls within your budget, you should definitely go with it, and it really fits my bills. So it really depends upon the purpose which you want. As I said before, this is totally suitable for indoor recording, and if it's a conversation sort of thing or one-to-one, and it's not really recommended if you want to take it outside. So it's not really built for those kind of consumers. So that is all for today. Let me know in the comments what kind of microphone do you use in your recordings, and I would be happy to check them out. And do check out the link in the description. You can actually get this HyperX Solocast, and it should work wonders. And do hit the like button and do subscribe to my channel. And if you are interested in travel things, you can definitely check them out, as more content would be coming soon. See ya.